thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on Local Gov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments. Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
If we could all sit down, please, and come to order. This is a special called meeting of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners here on October 24th, 2018 at 11 in the morning. First, I want to address and all five commissioners are present. We do have about approximately 10 people who were not able to come upstairs to attend the meeting because of the fire code and the amount of people who are allowed in this space. But we do want to note that we appreciate their presence and that they're going to be counted as attending the meeting. So before we get started with our business, if you would please, if you care to, join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we lift up our hearts to you this morning with praise and thanksgiving for this beautiful day. I pray that you would make us worthy of the task that you have put before us, that we would be people in this community who live with integrity and honor, who glorify you with our thoughts, words, and deeds, and that the meditations of our hearts and the words of our lips would be pleasing in your sight. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen.
If you would join me in the Pledge of Allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. The purpose of this meeting this morning is to discuss a request to the North Carolina Department of Environmental Quality, Division of Energy, Mineral, and Land Resources to consider holding a public hearing in Alamance County regarding a proposed quarry or mine which may or may not be built in the snow camp area. Before we get to that, I'd ask Mr. Albright to just give us a little bit about the background of the High Impact Development Ordinance. And
To avoid stepping on toes, may I just sit here?
Of course.
In general, in August of 2011, our planning board chairman prepared a memorandum to the board explaining the proposed heavy industrial development ordinance. The reasoning behind the initial review of the former high impact land use ordinance was the economic reality we faced in 2010 and 2011, with unemployment of 10 and 11%, and the inflexibility of the old ordinance. The planning board had determined that if an industry was presently located within the county and wanted to expand or wanted to move because of necessity or eminent domain or out of a desire to respond to some other company wanting to move them out, the current ordinance would likely render that impossible. And so the loss of industry and the inability to attract new industry under the old high impact land use ordinance placed the burden on residential property owners that were going to have to make up the difference for industrial commercial taxes that were paid. So they had determined that by having an inflexible ordinance, they would not create a climate conducive to business. That was their belief at the time. So they conducted an effort, meeting in a committee from March 2011 to May 2011, to write a new ordinance, which is the Heavy Industrial Development Ordinance, and balance between property rights, environmental concerns, and business concerns. And that was their goal. That was their mandate from the board, and that's what they came up with. The differences between the old ordinance and the new ordinance, the main difference is the tiered system of industry classification. And the second difference was the requirement of permit renewals. Every 3 years, the industry would have to show that they were still maintaining the required spacing and buffers and that type of thing. Additionally, they used our GIS mapping capabilities to show spacing and buffers to provide more transparency to the public. So both ordinances allowed for land spacing, but if the industry was unable to meet the necessary requirement under the old method, the new ordinance proposed that a variance could be applied for. So that was the, in a nutshell, that's the reason why we have the heavy industrial development ordinance that was approved by the board in 2011 at its regular meeting.
Great, thank you very much. And so the Alamance Aggregates project was approved according to that ordinance?
Yes, I reviewed the file with our planning director very carefully, and every element of the heavy industry development ordinance was met. Our former planning director was very thorough in that she made sure they met every element, including the spacing of 2,000 feet.
Great. I'll open it up if anybody has any questions for Mr. Albright about.
I'd like to ask, did Ms. Hodges approach you for any review or advice or analysis of what she was doing versus what the ordinance said?
No, she's not approached me in the application of this ordinance since she was employed here. She also approved many, many solar farms and other industries based on this same ordinance. There's really no need, I think, for her to ask me any questions because she followed the ordinance. But she did not contact me.
No,
I'm sorry, we're not entertaining questions from the audience today.
I thought you'd ask somebody.
Thank you. No, that's true, I did, but it was from my fellow board members. Thank you, though. Do any of the other commissioners have any questions for Mr. Albright about the ordinance or the permitting of Alamance Aggregates?
I guess my biggest question is the pipeline that is supposedly running through the property. And I was looking through my emails trying to pull that back up. We've gotten a response that Colonial was not contacted. Is that correct?
I don't know that they were or were not contacted, but it would not surprise me to learn that the person developing the aggregate property has an agreement with the pipeline company. Many of these companies have easements and encroachment agreements, and also, and I think Duke Power has a similar thing if you're building an industry or...
We have a representative of the pipeline company
here. I'm sorry, we're not entertaining any questions or comments from anybody. Yeah, well, we're not doing that. This is the purpose of this right now is to find out about the ordinance and to discuss that, and then the pipeline questions really, I think, would be addressed by the state. If we do have the state come in, then that would be the appropriate time to have those questions. So, ma'am, that's enough, because we're here to get through the meeting and to see about whether or not we're going to have the Department of Environmental Quality who's going to come and hold a public meeting, at which time the public will be able to share all of its concerns and questions at that time. So
if I may further respond to Commissioner Boswell, the Department of Mining, that I believe the board is going to ask them to come to this county and have a public hearing, that is probably one of the questions they will ask, because they, if there is significant public interest in the application, they can come to the county and hold a public hearing and take questions from folks like like folks that are here today. And some of those concerns can be expressed and dealt with by the mining department. Our role essentially is over. We've issued a permit,
right,
and it falls to the state now to determine whether safe mining practices will be met.
Well, walk me through that process. What do we do as a board to make that happen?
You can do it by letter. You can ask that the manager send a letter to the North Carolina.
If I may interrupt, Mr. Albright, yes. I think that's what our county manager is going to make a presentation about.
Oh, okay.
About that.
I'm sorry. I thought he was just here to make a decision.
No,
I need a little information before I make one. Thank
you. Of course, yeah, we all do. And Mr. Hager is well-prepared to talk about that process.
Before Mr. Haygood speaks, I hope I'm allowed to talk. I would like to ask the Colonial not to give a response short of, can you put it in writing what you would have said today and what your analysis of the situation is? Would you do that and put it to our county manager or county attorney?
We'd be happy to.
Thank you.
Thank
you. That would be wonderful. That's a great suggestion, yeah. Mr. Sutton. Thank you. All right, Mr. Haygood, where do we go from here?
Well, good morning, commissioners. As County Attorney Albright indicated, the county's review of this permit application for Alamance Aggregate has been completed. That process is over. At this time, the state permit process application review is underway. The county received notice of the state permit application by Alamance Aggregates on October the 1st by letter, and it indicated in the information from the state and the notice that there was a 30-day period for written comments to be submitted to the state of North Carolina. And I've spoken with the staff at the mining program with the state, and they indicated, as Mr. Albright mentioned, that if the Board of Commissioners so choose, the board could vote to request that the state, as part of their permit review process, hold a public hearing in Alamance County. That's apparently not always the process for the state, but if the state determines that there's significant public interest, they take that under advisement and will consider coming here to have a public meeting here in Alamance County. So I think what you're here today to talk about is that an action that the board would want to take. Do you want to formally vote to, you can direct me to send a letter on behalf of the board per your vote to the state requesting that they do consider coming to Alamance County as part of their review process. My discussions with the state staff indicated the following. If the state of North Carolina mining folks do come to Alamance County for a public hearing, they would announce that date. They would receive oral and written comments from citizens in Alamance County. So folks here that wanted to come, of course, would know when the date of the meeting is. They could attend. They could send written comments to the state for that night or come themselves to speak or speak in person or bring written comments with them at that time too. Generally, the state sets a time limit at these meetings for 3 to 5 minutes, very similar to what we do, but so you would have some time limit on speaking. The sign-ups to speak would be done on the site, wherever it was hosted. And they indicated that if they do hold a public hearing in Alamance County, it would certainly be an evening meeting, probably starting at 6 p.m. So at this point, if the commissioners desire, you can vote as a body to direct me to send a letter to the state asking for them to come.
Would this be our responsibility to coordinate and have a facility to do this in?
What I've told the state mining staff was that we would be happy to do that if the commissioners want to petition the state to come for a public hearing, that we would work with them to find a location that could be in a county property, or if they wanted to try to hold it in the community, we would work with them to find a location in the Snow Camp area, either way. But we would be
It's pretty evident there's a lot of concern in the community out there, and I think whatever we do, we need to at least have space big enough for everybody.
That's right.
Yes. Given the level of community and public interest in this project, if it's okay with you, I'd like to go ahead and make that motion to request the Department of Mining, whatever
that.
It is.
I'll second that.
Okay, I have a draft of a motion here to clarify which you might be making a motion. Would you be moving that the board direct the county manager to send a letter to the North Carolina Department of Environmental Quality, Division of Mining, and request that the department conduct a public hearing in accordance with 15A NCAC 05B.0111, big A, in Alamance County on the application for a new mining permit filed by Alamance Aggregates LLC, and that the manager offer the use of Alamance County public facilities and facilitate
that's exactly
that meeting.
What I was moving with the provision that I would also recommend he makes a phone call letting him know the letter is on its way.
Great idea.
In addition
right.
to.
All right.
I'll second all that.
Wonderful. So, is there further discussion from the board?
In regards to this issue, I would like to say that to compare this project to a solar farm is apples and
oranges.
Not even oranges.
All right, if there's no further discussion from the board, then we have a motion and a second. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Anyone opposed? All right, thank you so much.
So I can add, can I add something else?
Of course.
I mean, this is one issue, and this is about what we can do in this one particular application, but I would like to see us move in a direction to prevent this from happening again. I mean, we were talking to the Farm Bureau the other night, and the issue about countywide zoning came up, and I'm not suggesting we have countywide zoning. I mean, if this is what the community wants, I would be in favor of it. Might be in favor of it anyways, but we ought to start talking about it and maybe initiate some sort of a formal process to look into it.
I don't want to cut off anybody else from saying anything, but I personally absolutely agree. I think that the planning board is the proper venue to start those things, that that's their kind of jurisdiction to start out with that stuff. And I believe that our planning director is planning to take that up at the December meeting with the planning board.
Great.
And the high industrial development ordinance, and take it, we can always learn and grow and do better, and being stagnant is never good, and respond to challenges and situations. So
do we know other, are there other counties that don't have countywide zoning or something similar?
Oh, Lord.
In North Carolina?
Yes.
North Carolina.
I did say that Chatham County only got countywide zoning just relatively recently, mostly because of the Chatham Ridge subdivision, or development. It's not a subdivision, it's a town in Chatham County. So. All right.
Well, before we adjourn, I would like to say publicly, apply to our planner, we don't need to do a ordinance. Now, I'm not going to lie to you. I was on this board when we voted for that, and I guess we all did. I don't remember. But we don't need to be copying ordinances from another county. We need to look at what was out there. We need to create an ordinance that works for us and make sure that everything's included. It needs to be included. Again, this was basically a copy from where? What county?
The
original was,
The original was from Allegheny County. This one was completely our creation. The planning board subcommittee met for several months and came up with this on their own. So it's our
order. I remember that. That's way
so it didn't ride the backs of Allegheny?
It did not, because the goal was balance industry and property rights, and the spacing and the tiered requirements met that goal.
Spacing was the biggest element of that.
That's correct. Yeah.
All right. Well, wonderful. If there's no other business before the board, we'll be adjourned.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Alamance
County Commissioners
are the first and third Monday of every month in the Commissioners' Chambers at the County Office Building at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month occurs at 9 a.m. and the second meeting occurs at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the county website at www.alamance-nc.com. The video of this meeting is broadcast on LocalGov TV. Please go to www.localgovtvnc.com for more information about this schedule and to see more videos produced by your local governments. You can also access this meeting through our website at www.alamance-nc.com or at our YouTube channel. Technical questions regarding this meeting's broadcast or production may be sent to our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. This address is for technical questions only. Comments and questions about the content of the meeting may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. There, you can click on the link that says County Commissioners to learn more about our commissioners, read minutes and agendas of commissioner meetings, and find other information about the County Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments.